How big is the solar system?
It's a very good question, because there is no definite limit in our solar system, but the most of the mass is concentrated in the Sun. 99% of the mass is in the Sun, and only a small part in the rest. Planets, satellites, small bodies. The modern vision of the solar system is the Sun more or less in the center of the system, 8 planets: Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune, the moon of these planets, and many, many small bodies, asteroids, comets. We have 2 belts of small bodies. The main belt asteroid between Mars and Jupiter, and the Kuiper belt very, very far from Neptune.
What are the stars formed by?
The stars are formed by gas, hydrogen and helium. But in the center of the Sun, the temperature is so high that hydrogen is transformed in helium by the nuclear fusion reactions. And so, in the times, in the millions, in the billions of times, the stars create the elements. Inside the star, helium, carbon, oxygen are created by this reaction of the nuclear reaction. In the bigger stars, you can arrive to create hydrogen. So we can say that the stars are the alchemical medium, because they create the elements. The same elements that form your bodies, the carbon, the oxygen, one time was created inside the stars.
What can we expect from the Sun in the future?
The future of our Sun is determined by the mass of the star. I mean that a star like our Sun will become a giant, a red giant star, but in 3-4 billions of years. So no fear about the Sun in the next days, okay? But in the next 3-4 billions of years, the Sun will become very big. A red giant star that will finish its life like a dwarf, a white dwarf. It's a very slow process. The bigger stars is different. For them, they explode like a supernova. It's an incredible phenomenon of astronomy. And the supernova will improve the material of the universe with the elements that the stars created in their center.